Hi there, I am Giuseppe Corcella from Virtual Orchestration, and today I'm going to review British Drama Toolkit Brass and Reeds by Spitfire Audio. First of all, I want to thank Spitfire Audio for kindly sending us a copy of their library to review. British Drama Toolkit Brass and Reeds is a library created in collaboration with award-winning composer Samuel Sim, which combines different instruments from the brass and reeds families to create interesting mixtures. Recorded in Castle Sound Studios in Edinburgh, this library is also part of the Drama Toolkit collection. It requires 8 GB disk space during installing, and it's NKS compatible. It usually sells for €199, but at the time of this review, it's on intro price for €149. It runs in its dedicated plugin. From this menu, you load the desired patch, and you also have a bit of information about them. Here you have the main engine, which automatically sets the performance of each note on one of these layers, depending on the velocity you are playing with. So you can really create something interesting just with one patch, playing with both ends. On the right side, you've got 2 faders. The left one controls the volume, while the right one adjusts the velocity sensitivity. In the lower zone, you've got the articulations, which are assigned to key switches. And if you press Shift and click on more of them, you can make them play together. In the second page, you have 2 mic positions, close and three, as well as a few parameters. Depending on the instrument and articulation loaded, you can have attack, release, tightness, and reverb. And from this menu, you can choose the type of reverb. Let's now hear how it sounds.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I think this library can serve very well for sketching or even to create some organic combinations of sound very quickly. You could basically write a complete cue with one patch only indeed. You can play melodies and drones, but I believe you can get the best out of it with textures. When you play long pedals, you can see that the sound actually changes. It's not static. The sound itself of the instruments is beautiful and the samples quite dry. So you can add your own convolution reverb without problem. Some different reverbs are included in the library and I enjoy how they sound. They cover different kinds and sizes. It's also interesting that you can mix together more articulations in the same patch because this increases your sounding and experimental possibilities. It's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support Virtual Orchestration, subscribe to the channel. Join our newsletter if you wish, hit the like button and don't forget to click on the bell icon to get notified as soon as we release a new tutorial or a new review. If you are new to the world of the virtual orchestration and you wish to learn more about it, or even if you are a pro or semi-pro looking to improve your skills, we offer private online lessons about virtual orchestration, mockup programming and how to use Dorico, Sibelius, Cubase and Logic Pro. Get in touch at info@virtualorchestration.it. I wish you a wonderful day and see you on the next review.